It's the highest rated show in all of cable television. This is Monday Night Raw.
This arena is so loud, I can barely hear myself think.
That's good. Maybe we won't have to listen to you speak. Michael Cole, can you...
He's the Lone Wolf.
There's two things I've come to learn about Baron Corbin. He doesn't like people, and he loves to cause chaos.
Some of the best observations you've ever made, Byron Saxton.
Thanks, Corey.
Making his way to the ring from Kansas City, weighing in at 275 pounds, Baron Corbin.
The Lone Wolf is a man who doesn't seem to play well with others because he says others always have a problem with losing.
Accomplished so much in his young career. Won the Money in the Bank ladder match. Former Golden Gloves boxing champion, NFL offensive lineman, turned champion in WWE.
Physique on EC3. This guy's got muscles in places most people don't even have places.
Talk about an incredible story. A superstar who left WWE years ago, reinvented himself, got himself in the best shape of his life, to your point, Corey, and now he is back in his words, in the top 1%.
Are you doubting him?
I'm just repeating what he says.
Corey, you gotta realize Byron spent most of his life in the bottom 99.
That's not true.
Superstars coming to this matchup with a lot to prove.
Here we go. And a quick kick out from Baron Corbin.
You need more to keep a man Corbin's size down.
I agree.
Back in the ring again.
Thunderous slam.
Cravat locked in. Now that'll do some serious damage.
Better stay right where he is.
You gotta believe this one's over. Oh, man.
You cannot underestimate EC3, guys. In his 5 years away from WWE, he's defeated competitors like AJ Styles, Kurt Angle, and Sting. How much can you prepare for a guy who's improved so much?
Well, I'll tell you what, it won't work. Trying to out-muscle EC3. He was in great shape during his early WWE career, but his fitness has improved even further. Guys, you're not gonna believe this. He's actually in the top 1%.
Let's delve back into the discussion of strategy when facing EC3. We heard from Corey before. Byron, what are your thoughts?
His ladder match NXT return proved EC3 can stand with high flyers and hard striker.
He might have it.
Nobody controls the pace of a match.
Oh, what impact. Got every ounce of that one. This could be over.
I don't know if Corbin can recover.
I hate to agree with you, but you're right.
Big elbow.
The end of days. Oh, it's over.
There's the cover. Can he do it? He's got some fight left in him.
Just power out.
He's a long way from a three count, I can tell you that.
Too soon. What a stomp.
Good grief.
Now the old vicious head crank.
Look at the torque. Nasty attack to the neck. Oh boy, he is rolling.
I think we know what this is.
Oh, that's what he was looking for, Michael.
Oh, he's able to reverse it.
Baron Corbin just too fast for him. Shoulder tackle.
He goes down hard.
Yeah, he's not looking very good at this point, Cole.
He's lining him up. Counter here.
Oh, boy, he is rolling.
On the shoulders here.
And it could be a long way down from there.
Ooh, what a jawbreaker. Here's his moment, Michael.
Here's the cover. One, two, three.
This singles contest has the victor.
Here is your winner, EC3.
Byron, take a look at this.
No good can come out of this, Michael.
I think business is about to pick up sooner rather than later.
And look at the quickness by EC3.
Wow. When this guy's on, look out.
Nasty impact.
But I don't know how much gas he has left, guys.
Things just went from bad to worse for Bobby Roode. Don't you dare get up, man.
Beautiful technique. We may be looking at our winner here, guys.
Himself on maintaining a veteran mindset because of that vast international experience.
He's only 24, Byron. That's incredible.
It's amazing.
Highly skilled. He's the first Israeli-born superstar to compete in WWE.
He's got a little bit of his own swag going, too.
He's smug. He's not.
What a great match we have here to start off this night, guys.
And Michael, I had to check twice when I saw this match listed as our opener. I mean, it could very well have been our main event.
Singles action is underway, and in this one, I wouldn't attempt to predict what's going to happen. I'd just be ready for anything. Sometimes that's all you can do.
And I can't help but get the feeling that this is going to be one of those matches people will be talking about for a long time to come.
And I can't help but wonder how the champ's game plan differs, if at all, knowing that the title is not on the line here tonight.
Him off guard there, I guess.
Too early in the match to end it. Overhand right lands,
but he's got to capitalize now.
Here it comes. He's got him. Going for broke.
It's heating up now.
And a pin attempt.
One, two.
There's not a person in this arena who thought that that was it for him.
It's going to take more than that.
Now the old vicious head crank.
Look at the torque.
Oh, continuing to punish them.
He's starting to show signs of fatigue. We all know, though, this guy has plenty of fight left in him.
Let's not get ahead of ourselves, Cole. This is just a little bump in the road for him here. Nothing to worry about.
I know it's early, but he has to do everything in his power not to let this get out of hand.
This might be it.
Oh, my.
He's struggling a bit here. You have to wonder if he could recover from this, guys.
He's really starting to look fatigued here, guys. And when that happens, your whole body starts to give out on you. He's going to need to be careful here.
You can learn a lot about a guy in a match like this. And what I've learned so far here tonight is that there is absolutely no quit in him.
Bad move there.
I don't know what made him think that was a good idea.
Toss into the cartwheel and a knee strike. What a combination.
This just might be enough for him to take the victory here. You better stay right where he is. Stay down, man.
Oh, nasty impact.
Wow, I'm just as surprised as you guys are.
Whoa, he lets him out.
What a fool. He had him dead to rights.
Right, it's cinched in. This could be it.
Oh, my God, a small package driver.
That's how you put an exclamation point on the end of a match, guys.
We're knowing Dolph.
Yes, takes it.
Here is your winner, Kushida.
Kicking off the night with an impressive victory.
Yeah, the performance put forth in that match tells me we're looking at somebody who will someday, very soon, be competing in the main event.
What a way to kick off tonight. Don't go anywhere, folks. We're just getting started.
Carrying on the legacy of the legendary Hart family in sports entertainment. Natalya always ready to handle things inside the ring.
Yeah, the daughter of Jim the Anvil Neidhart, the niece of WWE Hall of Famer Bret the Hitman Hart.
Got the power of her father and the finesse of her uncle.
Guys, what better way to start the night off than with this one?
I can't think of a better match to kick the night off, Michael. In fact, we haven't even gotten started yet, and I can assure you that this will be a tough match to follow.
You can expect these superstars to put their bodies on the line to take each other down.
These superstars have waited a long time for this match to take place.
Aside from Saxton's commentary, this has all the makings of an epic match.
The Pirate Princess Kairi Sane has won championship gold everywhere she set sail during her illustrious career.
Yeah, that includes becoming the first ever Mae Young Classic winner. Sane may look sweet, but she is a force to be reckoned with in the ring.
Going for the cover.
Digging deep for a kick out.
Looks like there's some more fight left in her.
Beautiful technique. All measured up.
Things are about to pick up, guys.
I love a good plot twist.
Well, Nelson, Dragon Suplex. Hooked up.
And mention of Gooch Lever.
Absolute.
We got a cover.
Digging deep for a kick out. Pinning Kyrie. I'd say that's an insane endeavor.
I'd say you're right.
What a stomp.
Good grief.
Seen her withstand worse in the past, though.
Pump the brakes a bit, Cole. I know exactly what you're thinking, and I can tell you with all certainty, she still has plenty of gas left in the tank.
How she responds to this is going to be very important moving forward. She simply cannot let it take her out of her game plan.
What an elbow drop!
The competition was fierce at the first ever Mae Young Classic. NXT stars, top international talent, some former WWE performers all converged in a field of 32. But there could be only one victor, and that winner was the Pirate Princess, Kairi Sane.
Look at her go!
Michael brought us back to the inaugural Mae Young Classic. After 31 matches, it all culminated in the finals held in Las Vegas as thousands of fans and a handful of top WWE stars and...
Chief, what a strike. Right on the mark.
Victory is on the horizon.
Kairi Sane, big move coming. Insane elbow.
Man, she knows.
There's a pin now.
There's the pin. It's over. It's all over.
Here is your winner, Kairi Sane.
Big win here to start the show.
And you just know the rest of the card is watching in the back, wondering how in the world they're going to follow that.
Believe it or not, that's just the beginning, folks. Stay tuned for more great action.
This is gonna be fun.
On the way to the ring, at a combined weight of 650 pounds, Otis Dozovic and Tucker.
They're not different. They're a little unorthodox, but they're fun to watch, and they know how to get the job done.
Certainly lead to a few oat sodas after the match tonight. Dozovic and Knight, two tough, tough individuals.
Byron, are you friends with Anderson and Gallows?
I'd like to consider myself on good terms with them.
Because they talk about you a lot.
Oh, yeah? What do they say?
They say, nerd!
And their opponent, at a combined weight of 5.
around the world. Bona fide legends in the land of the rising sun. Anderson and Gallows, two of my favorite people to be around outside of the ring, because inside, they're all business.
I'd like to hang out with Anderson and Gallows outside of the ring.
You would never be invited to Brother Softly with these two guys.
I'd like to have abs like Anderson.
Oh, yeah, me too. Both little men are in the ring and set to start things off here. We're ready to go.
Ouch. The world rejoiced when Gallows and Anderson dethroned Cesaro and Sheamus to win the Raw Tag Team Championship. Winning those titles was the main reason Anderson and Gallows came to WWE. And to win them as part of the Royal Rumble kickoff special made it even better.
We may be looking at a powerbomb here.
That's exactly what it looks like to me, Cole.
When Gallows and Anderson won the tag team titles for Raw, they became just the third duo in sports entertainment history to hold the IWGP Tag Team Championship in Japan and WWE Tag Team Gold.
No one would ever suggest that Gallows and Anderson are not an elite tag team. You don't win the Raw Tag Team Championship by just dumb luck. But the way they won the titles left a bad taste in some people's mouths. And into a quick cover is Luke Gallows.
And kicking out is Tucker Knight.
Gonna take a whole lot more.
Harsh impact.
He's not looking like himself here. This tag team match can get out of hand quickly if he doesn't mount an offense soon.
It's no secret that quick tags lead to success in the tag team division. And I'd say the quicker he can make that tag here, the better their chances of winning will be.
Tag made. What are we going to see?
Oh, holy cow!
Double back body drop.
Wow. Oh, what a clothesline.
Forcefully delivered.
It's that time. To the body. Oh, he turns it around. And look, it hung up on the second.
Get in there, ref. Oh boy, he is rolling.
Starting to look defeated out there.
He needs to find a way to create some space or else this thing's over.
He has got to fight back.
There's no way to sugarcoat this one.
Earth-shaking spine buster from the good brother himself.
Just when you thought he had nothing left.
Lands this and he is done.
Shoulder tackle.
In off the tag. What a stomp.
Good grief.
Luke Gallows in some trouble here. If they want to win this match, he really needs to make a tag soon.
You know, I thought this match was going to be much more tightly contested.
I guess that's not the case, though.
Anderson is letting his feelings be known.
An incredible combination.
Ooh, just dropped.
There may be no escaping this fireman's carry.
I don't know. Never say never, Cole.
Oh, my God, what impact.
This is what makes him one of the best in the business.
He's too quick for him there.
Shoulder tackle.
Irish whip.
Otis Dozovic got out of there in time.
Carl Anderson tags in.
That'll hinder your modeling career.
Takes him down
in a major way, too.
His partner's calling for the tag.
Yeah, he's not done yet.
And looking for
the drop kick hits the mark.
But he's running on fumes here.
Does he have enough left in him to capitalize?
Momentum is fully in the corner of Carl Anderson now.
Luke Gallows tagged in.
Oh, he's got him here. He's got him up.
Sidewalk slam.
Almost drove him through the ring.
Check this out.
Oh, what a backbreaker.
Man, just ugly impact.
Nailed it. Oh.
Just when you thought he had nothing left.
All that's left now is for Gallows to finish this.
Oh, don't worry.
They got it.
Here are your winners, Luke Gallows and Carl Anderson.
Another exciting tag team match in the books.
Yeah, the performance put forth in that match tells me we're looking at somebody who will someday, very soon, be competing in the main event.
Plenty more action still to come here tonight, folks.
What a great match we have here to start off this night, guys.
And Michael, I had to check twice when I saw this match listed as our opener. I mean, it could very well have been our main event.
his opponent, from Davenport, Iowa, weighing in at 217 pounds, Seth Rollins.
Guys, what better way to start the night off than with this one?
I can't think of a better match to kick the night off, Michael. In fact, we haven't even gotten started yet, and I can assure you that this will be a tough match to follow.
The bell, and here we go. This is the type of battle that you could show someone who's new to our brand of entertainment and say, this is what WWE's all about.
And it looks to me like this entire arena is on its feet, and understandably so.
The best laid plans often go awry, but the architect has always been able to rebuild and redesign.
Yeah, but it's that reclaiming part at the end of his saying that Seth Rollins often gets tripped up on.
He goes for the cover. He's a long way from a three count, I can tell you that.
Yeah, it's gonna take more than that.
Oh, man! You gotta believe this one's over. Just not looking good here.
Well, we all know that he isn't afraid of a good fight, which is what we're seeing here.
Well, he had to expect to take some punishment tonight. You don't step in the ring with this guy and walk away completely unscathed.
Oh, man.
What a headbutt.
Vicious.
Ooh. Seth Rollins got out of there in the nick of time.
He should count his lucky stars.
Absolutely has to get back in the ring.
There's no way around it.
He wants no part of the outside.
Two.
Whoa, Rollins really dodged that one.
It's so quick for a man of his size.
Elbow drop. Seth Rollins beginning to fade.
Joe Rollins
makes the cover. An easy kick out there.
It's way too early.
And set him up the knee to the ears.
That's gonna hurt.
He's cheating, Rip! He's cheating!
Stop being such a tattletale, Cole.
And he kicks out.
Definitely has his work cut out for him.
He's making a statement here with this attack.
Pulls the trigger.
Slay the king.
I knew it was only a matter of time.
I don't like the look in his eye here, folks.
Stationary position, turns around.
Whoa, what impact.
There's the pin. Can his opponent kick out?
Yeah, he's got a lot left in him.
Not yet. What a stomp.
Good grief.
Oh, big slam. Uh-oh, he's in trouble here.
See if he takes the bait. He wants no part of this.
Looks to me like he's looking for the win.
Two, three.
There's the pinfall and the victory.
Here is your winner, Seth Rollins.
And help has arrived here from Rusev. We all knew this situation was going to explode sooner rather than later.
Harsh impact.
Oh boy, he is rolling.
We've seen that. Oh, what a roundhouse kick.
That should do it.
Oh no, Seth Rollins needs to worry now.
Yeah, the clock's ticking on the Kingslayer.
Rusev's feeling it. Half Nelson applied. Seth Rollins has him right where he wants him.
He'd be wise to stay right there.
That's how you wear down your opponent.
Oh, going right after the neck.
Here he goes.
This just ain't gonna do it.
Looking at it a second time.
That might just be the final nail in the coffin.
This is not good. I don't think Rusev knows where he is.